I'm going back to the Hade Spear, I think.
Yeah. You definitely want to attune some range to weapons, because in order to get the DLC for the...
Attune some ranged weapons.
Some ranged attacks.
Like spells?
Yeah, like lightning spear and stuff like that.
Yeah, I should already have those.
Okay, good.
I might switch this out for a fireball or green fireball.
The enemies that we want to get the key for the one DLC from are in a fire are fire based, so we might want to do flash sweat.
Sure. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And we still cannot afford great lightning, I don't think.
No,
we can't afford heaven with thunder. We cannot afford a great lightning spear.
Right. Yeah, that's 42 faith. We're getting there though.
We're getting there. Slowly but surely, we're getting there.
Alright, you typed up the update.
And actually, I'll go ahead and get the black bow up too. If you think that would be a good idea.
Yeah, I think so.
So plus 7. Anyway, we've got 74 wood arrows and 29 iron. So. All this feels when I put on some magic arrows or whatnot.
Yeah.
So. Destructive great arrows. That's right, we don't have any great arrows. Or great bows, though.
Right.
We only have mediocre ones.
Yeah, we have an okay bow.
Okay, so we're... That's an okay roll.
It's not a great roll.
It's not a fast roll, but it's not a fat roll. So.
Right.
Okay, so where are we going to get...
The first one we can get right here. Remember the... When we got the Forgotten Key, we went down the ladder into the pit there in Majula. And we found the door with the witch tree staff and stuff like that.
I think so.
Yeah, it's in there. Somehow we missed a corpse, you know, in that room, apparently.
In here?
Yeah. I think you want to go down the middle ladder.
This one?
No, the other one.
That
one? Yeah.
Yeah. It's actually the rightmost, if you're looking at
it. Well, I meant a middle length. You hold down
which the... would be this one, I think.
Yeah. You can hold down the button. There you go. And, we'll eventually we'll have to get the cat ring and go in there, or yeah, we want to end for fall control.
But we do have the cat ring.
Oh, yeah. So sometimes we can just go get those goodies. I think there's a missing service up there. It's probably not to have that. And anyway, what we want to do is, maybe we had to take the longest ladder down and then go up. Yeah, I think that's what we had to do. We had to take the longest ladder down and then go up the next one. So, well, you can take a look around.
Same with the pools of blood. I can't actually hit A to get up the ladder again.
Should be able to cycle through, no?
Nope.
No. Huh. Well, in that case, just go to the edge, go like to your left from here a little bit. What you want to do is take a running start and then jump off the other side. And get over to where the other message is. We can still make this work.
Okay. Actually, I think the safest thing would be do it from this side.
That's what I meant. Yeah, run to where you are now and then jump across. There we go.
Okay. And now there.
That's the way to the Grave of Saints.
So we don't want to go there.
Yeah.
Well, if I go down here, that'll be where...
Where that ladder would take you. Yeah, so just do that.
Okay.
Eesh, that was close.
Good thing we got the ring.
And then go up that ladder.
This one?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so many ladders here. I don't know which one does which.
There we are.
And yet, apparently... Keep looking around. Yep.
Aha.
Wow.
There we are.
Oh my gosh.
No word bone out.
Might as well.
Wow. Although, then again, can't I just use the ladder and climb out?
You could, yeah.
Yeah.
Give me time to go type this up.
We can use a homeward bone if we don't have to, so. Then watch me have plummeted off and died. Would have been just my luck. I've forgotten how long a climb this is, though. Where are we going after this?
You will. First thing I'm going to do is go to Iron Keep at the first bonfire. and just run straight ahead into the big room where the flaming, like, the bullhead used to be.
Mm-hmm.
And so make sure we got that key. Oh, actually, no, we can check. Go to hit start. Go to our items, and then our key items. And look and see if we have, like, an iron key. Yeah.
There we do.
Oh, the iron door of the Iron Keep. I think that's it. Yeah. Yeah, in that case, you go to the Force of Fallen Giants, you go to the second bonfire, and then we go to where the last giant was. So down the ladder, to hang a right, and then go down the elevator.
Down the ladder.
Okay. Cold, throw this whole spirit key.
Let's go back to the ring of blades of the silver cavern. There we are. There it is.
HTTP. Twitch.tv slash boop gamers.
Yes, and we have not extincted these things.
Right.
I don't know. There we go.
Submit.
You get a post on the internets.
Indeed. Okay.
I believe it was through here, wasn't it?
Hey, Sway.
Hey, Sway.
Aw. Yeah, you'll have to get on to him about that.
There we
are. That's doing a lot of damage.
It's definitely more like it.
Not that you went too far. Down the elevator.
Down the elevator.
Mm-hmm. Which is what I said.
I just remembered the down the stairs part.
Yep.
Okay, elevator is
right there.
Mm. Ah. That's right. The other way is to the sewer fight.
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, Nilheim.
Hey, Nilheim. Welcome, welcome. Well, that way is full of fire. Let's not go that way.
That is the way we'll be going.
Through the fire?
Uh huh.
Hmm.
Not through the... No, no,
oh,
no.
Oh, I can tell this is going to be a long stream already. Right?
No.
Well, it'll be fun.
You go straight ahead. Yeah. And then, yeah.
Well, I figure that now.
Yeah, this will be an interesting one. You know, Ben's leg is still broken, and I have a cold. So,
I think I finally extincted that one.
Yay!
Yay! Oh, and this one too, it looks like.
Oh, they are a package deal.
Yeah. Pretty much. Okay. This is how I do not fight the other ones, because I don't have to.
Right. Maybe we'll go straight ahead and then left through the locked door. And then that'll take us to the area with all the fire. I don't think you literally have to walk through it, though.
Is it the thing?
Yeah. I think it's like the only S-Talk hollow left.
Yeah.
And Scholar. They turned a lot of them into the Bastard Sword guys. And there it is, Iron Key. Let's see if they change this any in Scholar. This is one of the hardest areas in the original because the salamanders are just such a pain to fight.
Whoa! See what you mean.
Yeah, they're just really gimmicky. They do tons of poise damage. They can hit out of nowhere. You can't parry them, of course. You have to try to, you know, fight them the best you can. A lot of people will just hang back and poison them.
Unfortunately, that isn't really a tactic they can use.
Well, you have poison arrows.
I suppose that's true. Ow, what the?
Yeah, and they can. And when you start getting close to the other ones, they have that three fireball attack from when you went to get the fire longsword.
Nice.
So you can't get too far away. You got to the boss with a hole in his face. That would be the first boss, right?
Yeah, Lost
the
Giant.
The last giant. Yeah.
The one that like breaks his arms to get out of the chains that he's in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically for him, you kind of have to try to stay behind his feet and bash his ankles over and over again. And I mean literally bash too. The strike weapons do the most damage to him. If you're in human form, you use one of the human effigies, and you talk to. Like, you remember when you saw there was a room with the ballista, and the ladder down and all that. If you talk to Pate, you go through that locked room, and you either die or complete that area. And if you're human, he'll help you out against the giant. And with an NPC to distract him, you should be okay. And yeah, good call. And this is what I recommended Flash Sweat for, so you could kind of trade range attacks with him. This first guy, you could probably kill in melee. It wouldn't hurt to... That's not bad.
Okay, so he can't actually...
Yeah, he can't get in there. Yeah, and with your the extra fire resistance, you're not taking too much damage there. Yeah.
Yeah, they attack really, really quickly.
Yeah, they attack quickly. They do a lot of the poise damage, so you have to have a very stable shield to block them.
Do they do fire damage as well as physical?
I think they only do physical with their bashes, and they only do fire with their fireballs. I believe.
Something seems off somewhere. Because, yeah, that's 100% block, but I was still taking damage.
Because it kept knocking you down. It was breaking your guard. Yeah, you need something with a lot of...
I mean, even when it hit me with its tongue.
Oh, maybe it does do fire damage, too. In that case, switch shields to the...
I think I'll go ahead and just... Because the Flash Sweat should help against the that fire, too.
Yeah. Yeah, and I believe Flash Sweat gives you more fire resistance than Great Magic Barrier does.
Yeah, that's why I would...
Yeah. Because Great Magic Barrier is like 30% across the board, so it's good, but... There we go.
Actually, you know what I'm going to do?
Mm-hmm.
Well, first I'm going to do this. Yeah. This is a good idea. Then I'm going to go ahead and do this number.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the shield is basically worthless against these guys. That's not bad, actually. Yeah, and apparently they're... Oh, yeah, they definitely do. Yeah, I read that their underbellies take extra damage when they're... Something just took 600. Something just could die and gave you 600 souls. Yeah, that's not bad.
That is a much better way of handling this.
Yeah, you could switch to your poison arrows and start and hit with a couple of those to start softening them up, and then use the other things.
Yeah.
Because those should only take 3 or 4 arrows to poison them.
Sure.
Yeah. It's pretty obvious to tell when Flash Sweat wears off. There he is. I wonder if that's the one you can see trying to go for the Fire Longsword. If so, you can probably kill him from the other side. About one more. There it is. And once you see the health start ticking down really quickly, then...
Let's just use some regular wooden arrows to hold that along.
Yeah. Those arrows are doing a lot of damage.
Yeah.
It's like 200 onto the sides and like 500 to the belly. It's pretty strong. Because that's because your dex is so high.
Boy, am I glad that I also got arrows for us.
Yeah.
Okay, are there only two or are there more?
There are two in this area, and there are, I think, two more up the hill. But you should be able to deal with them the exact same way. It's not exciting, but it works.
That's the thing. It's like, you know, maybe I could do some amazing, fanciful, dodgy stuff and put on an entertaining show. But also entertaining is not dying every 2 seconds.
Right. Mm-hmm. Oh, there it is. That's new.
There's the iron key.
Yeah, and that kind. Yeah, that is the one. Yeah, that's where the longsword is. Yeah. So yeah, I guess to make it easier, what you could do, because you can kill him without any problems if you use the open door as a cover, mm-hmm. and just step back and forth between it, shooting at him. Well, you didn't need to.
Then is there anything further up this one?
Yeah, there's the hawk ring for bows, and there's I think a fire drake stone, some other stuff. Yeah, this one will be a little trickier because he'll just be shooting fireballs at you. On the other hand, almost every shot will be a critical hit because of where his mouth is. Oh. Well, that was easy.
Good thing that enemy AI is a little... might die for just from poison.
Yeah.
Someone else has exactly the same idea.
Yep. Nice.
Glory to all the bow bros.
You know, Sway is always urging us to do some archery. I hope he's over internet behaves so he can watch this part.
So it's going to be just doing the fireball thing?
Until you get close, yeah. What I would do... You're probably going to clip the invisible... Yep. There we go. Oh, I think we got another one. Man, just the right pixel to stand at.
Yep.
See, you can aim a little bit lower and try to get the extra damage for him.
I don't think I'll be able to. Yeah, I'm not getting the huge spikes of damage.
Right.
I think it's mostly for when they're rearing up breathe at you.
Yeah. That makes sense.
The important thing is that all salamanders are now dead.
Yep. Yeah, and you can tell when they're all gone because the fire stops. Now, watch out because, it puts this red haze over it, I guess, from smoke or embers or whatever. And there are pits you can fall in.
That one there.
Yeah. Yep, so just be really careful walking around. That's a lesson that I can give you because that's the exact same thing happened to me. Right. I finally killed all those guys and...
And down you went.
Yep. I think that's the... Yep.
Excellent.
And it doesn't help us much in this game as it did in Dark Souls 1. Oh, there's a chest in the back corner.
Which
one? Opposite from where the ring was.
Over there?
Uh-huh. Hmm. I don't know what's in there, but... Oh, wait a minute. I don't think that was there before. I bet that's a mimic. Yep.
Actually, I'm not
sure. Or a trap, yeah. Nope, okay.
So it's not a mimic.
So it's probably just trapped, then. Either that or they were trying to run past the salamanders.
Yeah, it looks like that's a...
Yeah.
Which is really kind of stupid if you think about it.
Oh, the plus one. Oh, that's cool. They might have been trying to speedrun to grab that ring before they go to Iron Keep. Or I guess after... Well, no, because you get the ring... Because you get to turn off the machine to get the Iron Key and I don't know.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah. But regardless, those are the two keys to the other two DLC areas.
Oh, all right.
So now I get to decide which one to do.
You know, I'm just going to use a homeward bone to get us back home.
Yeah.
It's like, technically, it's a straight shot back, but...
Yeah, just a little bit of a walk plus the elevator.
Right. So, which DLC are we doing?
Well, this is normally where I hold a vote, but not too many people are here yet.
Indeed.
And the ones that are haven't played the game before. I guess if you want to, you can just do them in the order that they were released. And that would be Sunken King, Iron King, and Ivory King.
Sure. That sounds good to me.
All right, so the first one would be After the Rotten.
Let's see. Will I still need the flash sweater or anything?
Probably not.
In that case, I think I'll take the Great Combustion.
Yeah.
It's more... actually, I think I'll go ahead and take the Great Fireball instead.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I don't think we saw her last time because she didn't go that way. But... or did we? Did you get the steel ring plus one from Lucatiel?
I don't think so.
Yeah, she's actually in. Remember the in right before you fight Jabba, there is a hallway with poison that I said led to the poison bite ring, and you didn't bother going there.
I think so.
Yeah, she's in that room now.
Okay, but I don't remember where he is.
Well, she won't be there anymore because you beat the boss.
Okay.
So that's where she would have been. So they, actually, you know what? That's probably why she wasn't there for the rotten.
Oh, or, that could be.
Maybe, no, those are different areas, I think. And regardless, yeah.
So where is the Sunken King?
Black Gulch. I'm doing the last entries. Yeah, there you go, the green one.
Mouth or the
second one? Yeah, because it was right after the Rotten's boss room.
That's right. Wonder if I'll have to fight what's his face again.
Probably. Yeah, if he spawns until you extinct him, then you'll be at it for a while. So there's a glowy across the room from you.
In there?
Yeah.
I suppose I can. Well, he hasn't shown up.
Yeah, maybe he is dead. Killed him like 4 or 5 times, I think.
Right. Let's walk on over and see if I can get the shiny.
Yeah.
Something is likely going to spawn in here.
I can probably just get past the. There was one in there. Oh, there they are. Oh, that was a broken chest.
That's right.
Yeah. By the. I don't know what would have been in there. Moot point now.
Unfortunately.
I wonder if you bonfire ascetic, if you get another chance at those things.
Yeah, that's a good question. For now, though.
Yep. Oh, that is one. There was another one. And those flames never die down, though. Yeah, I think that's kind of a reference to it. I'm not sure what lights the Rotten's, pits on fire.
Yeah.
But in the area, the tar pits that those hand enemies spring out of, if you have a torch lit when you roll through them, or use a pyromancy to damage them or whatever, it will light those on fire.
Huh.
And do the exact same thing. I believe also if you light them on fire prematurely, it will drive those monsters out.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, yes, I remember them now.
Yep. Need money bags.
Well, let's try it out.
You probably won't be seeing that in the Scholar version because it comes with that built-in.
Right. The White Hollow Mage Room.
Yeah. Oh, I thought it would have been kind of a nice touch if picking a...
Didn't I already try to go through here?
Yeah, we did have the key, right.
Gotcha.
Because I thought you didn't need them because the DLC was built-in Scholar. What that means is that instead of starting with the keys in your inventory, like in Dark Souls 2 proper, instead you have to find them. Which, I guess is an improvement. Well, yeah. Well, it's an improvement over having to buy them.
Right.
Certainly.
I'm going to change my equipment around, actually.
Okay.
I'm going to move my bow over here.
All right.
Then my chime over on the other hand.
Yeah, fair enough.
So that way, whenever I'm casting, I'm always got my shield handy.
Yeah. And that makes sense.
So that's one thing that I need to remember, is like you can't cast and stab at the same time, or at least not very effectively.
Right.
There we go.
Yeah, if you had a spell that boosted your physical attack, that'd be one thing, but as it is, you don't.
If I had like Sunlight
Blade. Sunlight Blade, yeah. But Sunlight Blade is in Shrine of Amana. That's the next story location open, but it's a ways into it. And we'd be there for a little while. So I think it'd be fun to start the DLC.
I'm waiting for something to jump out and cheap shot me.
Probably nothing until you get to the first bonfire. Sholva Sanctum City.
Hmm. They have kind of the Maya-style ziggurats over there.
Mm-hmm. It looks pretty cool.
In an area that's probably really easy to fall off of.
Oh, yeah, look up.
Oh, my.
Yep. Lots of weaponry that Dragon Care was carrying with him.
Carrying. Yeah, in him is the word. So, the chances of me running to that guy again are pretty high, I'm guessing.
I would say 100%.
Yeah. Okay, bonfire verse.
Now, whenever true dragons appear in Dark Souls, they tend to be a pretty big deal.
Right.
And they tend to all have a reason why they survived.
Right.
All right, from here, I have never played this stuff. I've seen it done, but...
Okay.
I've seen it played, but I haven't acted in it myself, so it's not very fresh in my mind. A bunch of people trying to take a shortcut across, it looks like. Maybe they thought if they geared up with enough fall resistance, they could make it.
That could be.
Yeah.
But I'm not seeing that.
Yep. There are a couple of places in Dark Souls 1 where...
What's Old Growth Bomb?
That's new to the DLC, but I believe it increases one of your stats.
Let's see, it would be in here somewhere.
So then we only have a one of, and... Wait a minute, go up a couple?
That it's not... Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was on the left, and up one more. Yeah, there we go.
Strength. Oh, temporarily increases strength. Gotcha.
Wonder how long temporary is.
Not that it would help us a whole lot, but...
Yeah. And I would...
Try down and then attacking.
I'm willing to bet that is just going to be a quest shortcut later. Beware of the storm. Yeah, these are kind of like the DLC in... These are kind of like the DLC...
I definitely cannot make that drop,
no.
So.
But yeah, as far as I can tell, those are like the DLC for Dark Souls 1, where later on you'll get to the bottom part of that elevator... And then you'll send it back up, so you can then use it normally.
Yeah, definitely. That's definitely not tripping anything.
Aw.
Oh, sorry to hear that, Sway. Hopefully next time you'll have better luck.
Yeah. Yeah, remind him that Tuesday is Rupee Night, you know. We take priority. Yeah. Take care, Sway.
Yep, take care. So I can't do anything that way.
Yeah. And this whole shortcut system is kind of weird in this game because you start off being able to
use... I really don't see any...
No. Those are just there to mess with people, right. I think.
Well, if I can... Oh, hi.
We got our first enemy. So... A little bit of poison build up and a fair bit of damage. And not impossible poise, right. So... Or the fair few souls, too.
Definitely we'll have to be careful of that poison, then.
Yeah. Let's see. Did we end up with a poison bite ring? Might be worth it, too.
Let's find out.
Well, or are we good to switch our gear around? Oh, wait a minute. I think an enemy just popped up there. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there we go.
So, first things first. Run back over here and see if we have a poison bite ring. Not sure if we ever did get one or not.
Yeah, there was one we could have gotten later, but we did. No, okay, we don't have one. Yeah.
Well, none of the poison seems to be that bad.
Yeah.
So I'm not too worried about it yet.
Right. We'll just have to be careful.
Oh, that's a lot of them.
Ah. So this is the gimmick. I wonder if if I think using those great hammers too, you can't really get enough boys to do anything about that.
But they can only get at me from certain angles.
True.
That is going to be their undoing.
Right.
Okay. See some soldier guards.
Soldier gauntlets, huh?
So I bet that's where a lot of the bloodstains came from. Not from the one, but from the...
From the 3-on-1, right. Okay, they do have swords they can pull if need be.
But not well enough.
Yeah, so far so good.
Let's see, that is a drop I could...
Could drop down there, yeah.
Well, let's not go there yet.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a...
That is a full house.
Try try attacking. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, that's how you turn those switches. Yeah, I don't think they're gonna leave their archer cover, are they? You can coax them.
Saying, I just want to get that one going first.
And okay, there we go.
Ow. Oh, because it, I tried to lock on and I didn't, so I turned around.
Right.
Oh, well. There are a lot of archers in this area.
Yeah.
I am actually going to, once I get my souls back and I kill all those guys, I think I'm going to go run back to Majula and get more arrows.
Yeah.
Because I think I'm going to need a lot more before I'm
through. And given that you have, given your high faith, you might want to get lightning arrows from Wallager or fire arrows from Ornifex. Instead of just more iron arrows.
I was thinking wooden arrows myself, but yeah, that's a good point.
That probably did a bit more damage.
And they're all in the... Well, Ornifex is still in...
Brightstone Cove, right. Yeah. Hmm. We can just get more arrows. We can get some more wooden arrows, yeah. It'd be cheaper. Now you're getting a pretty good damage bonus from the black bow because of your high dex.
Exactly right.
You're making a lot more in souls than we're spending fighting these guys, so.
That's heavy bolts. That's right, he doesn't have any more iron arrows.
Yeah.
Which is kind of unfortunate, but.
Probably get a couple hundred of those.
Yeah, let's go with 100 and,
60. Make it 200.
159 should make it even 200.
Okay.
Isn't
it? Yeah. That you need an even amount, because you'll just be using those soon enough, but...
That makes me feel a little better.
Yeah.
Then who sells that mirrors?
I believe that's Chancellor Welliger and Drangleia Castle. So the first bonfire, then work your way up.
Let's find out for sure if that's the case or not.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, those four other grayed out bonfires are going to be the rest of the main game areas.
Right.
Then in the DLC. Quite a bit of DLC zones. And
wait a minute, this isn't the right one.
Yeah, you could keep going the way you were going, straight ahead. Then you up the ladder in this room. Then in that area, you'll be hanging left. And from there, it'll be up the stairs. Yep. They're pretty much chump changed now.
Which you will not hear me complain about.
Right. Aw. I still got him.
Yeah. So I was expecting to be able to...
To backstab him?
Yeah. So is it...
Through there. And then up the stairs. And he's right there in the middle.
It is a good question about how a ghost serves as a merchant, but...
Stranger things have happened.
Let's see.
Oh, wait a minute. Check out his inventory.
Oh, he sells a emblemless lacrosse. Uh-huh. That's cool. Yeah, let's go with 50 of these.
Okay. I was going to say, check out his weapons and armor. He's actually selling all of the pre-order stuff.
Yeah.
When we started doing that, it must have been when you killed Looking Glass Knight and declared Drain Lake Castle, because he wasn't when you first got here.
Right.
And the only good stuff of the pre-order things I ever found much of a use for was the Transgressor Shield, because it was really light, and I heard they nerfed it, so yeah, it's kind of a waste. And then the Transgressor Staff is good for Dark, but not as good as the Sunset Staff, which you cared about hexes you would have by this point. Right. So...
Yep, that would be the problem.
Yeah. Back to Shulva we go.
Yes.
I'm willing to bet pretty much all those enemies are going to be resistant to poison because they use it.
Yeah, that's what I would think.
And again, you never know. I mean, the most effective strategy against Smelter Demon was a poison the giant suit of armor with a living inferno inside. So
true, but he wasn't using poison.
That's true. That's true.
Yeah, but if we had tried to use fire against him, that wouldn't have worked so well.
Right.
Anyway, as a corollary to that, I will switch from poison to lightning.
Yeah. And I was going to actually ask if you want to switch to the stone spear to help the stone shield to help stone ring. I'll get it right eventually. To help poise break those guys, we already have it equipped. So without it, I bet it would probably take 3 hits to try to poise break them. There he goes. A fair bit of damage.
You're mine now, buddy.
they're not, he's not taking much from that.
Well, those are the wooden arrows.
Ah. Yeah, I think for this guy, it's probably worth fighting him directly. But then again, he has like 2 buddies, doesn't he?
Right.
Yeah.
Saying if I could fight him directly, I would, but...
Oh, you keep. Oh, it's not. That's barely doing any more. Oh, so it's still the wooden. It's okay. Yeah, what you can do is like to keep the thing locked on him and then roll forward when the arrows come at you.
Roll forward.
Yeah.
Well, I can't lock onto him anyway.
Well, not locked onto him, but I meant when you have the reticle up, you can roll forward as you're even with the bow drawn, and that'll help get past those arrows as they come flying in at you.
Interesting. Uh-huh.
Oh, it's catching invisible. Yeah.
I bet that one shouldn't be safe.
Yeah, there we go. Oh, it's an archer.
Both of those two are.
Ah.
They get some really good angles.
Yeah. Okay, they did rouse one of their buddies to try investigating.
I had honestly hoped that he would have fallen off.
He's a little bit closer than he would, yeah. Although that's the closest they get, though. You can probably shoot from there. You have to get a little further to the side. There you go. Somebody died.
Oh, so they aren't taking a lot from that, either.
No.
Yeah, barely more than the wooden ones, actually.
Yeah. Well, it's about half again as much, but yeah, you'd expect more. Alright.
Yeah, I definitely would have expected more, considering, how good our faith is.
Right. Well, it's like, I felt bad about telling Cattle about that, but no, it turns out why I got into backwards. And your stats will improve the scaling of an elemental infusion on the bow, but not the arrows.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it applied to everything, but not quite. Yeah.
Ow.
Yeah. And as they're recovering, So we know it takes 2 hits to poise break them. That is pretty good info. Yeah, we have a lot of life gems.
Indeed. That was my thought. There should be one more.
But yeah, if there's anything like the second DLC that I helped out one of the guys on Something Awful with, I wouldn't be surprised if everything in here just had really high elemental resistance. And Dark Souls 1's DLC was the same way. Magic was just really tough to use. They just made everything really, really resistant to it.
There we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems like that's one of the few ways they know how to increase difficulty.
Yeah.
Just make everything more resistant to everything.
Right.
Which is really unfortunate because that makes things just less interesting in general.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's another drop-down point.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I might start turning those switches and see what they do.
What switches?
Those things. Yeah, you can hit them.
Oh, hit them.
Huh? Ah, so that's what that one does. Hey, buddy. They look kind of like, so look kind of like old knight hammers, just, you know, like crystals in the end.
Huh. Well, there's an obvious problem here.
You know how to get up there?
I can't get up there.
Yep.
Huh. Okay.
Maybe you have to, can you send it again and send it back down? Okay, you can. Maybe you can, like, stand on the edge of it and hit the,
Actually, I thought I know what I need to do.
Oh, yeah, hit it and then hop onto it.
Right. Yeah. Well, not hop onto it, hop into it.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
Now I just need to... Well,
into it wouldn't do you any good, it didn't look like.
Oh, are you thinking there might be... Oh, there is something.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I was thinking of then using an arrow to get me back down. Then again, I guess I wouldn't need to, because... Unless there's something, you know, beneath the surface there. Which there might well be.
It might be, yeah.
And that was kind of my thought. Okay.
Yeah, and don't forget you can attack to do a plunge and stop and keep you from rolling.
Ooh, Dark Wart's Ring.
Throws three.
Dark Warts.
Dark Warcraft Ring.
I wonder what killed those guys.
Huh.
No, whatever.
Oh, they might have been trying to snipe the archers from there.
Oh, that could be. That'd be quite the trick, though. Well, for now, I'm going to go ahead and see if there is anything down there. Because
mm-hmm.
even if there is, I don't imagine that would be a... that would be something that would be the way that we need to go.
Right.
This definitely falls under the stop yanking me up and down and getting sick phenomenon.
Yeah, it's a good thing they built these stone elevators with no noticeable, you know, gears or anything to last.
Right. Oh, maybe it is.
Ah, so this is another area, it looks like.
Huh. Well, I can't make that jump, I'm pretty sure.
Right.
Or maybe I can. Yeah, they're Lorax.
Yeah. I don't know if it's a lot of other streams going on tonight or what, but yeah.
Oh, and this is back the other way.
Yeah.
Interesting. Okay. Well, I will go ahead and try to make that jump because I can't see any other way to make it.
Right.
And to improve my chances of success.
I don't think that impacts anything in this game, but it couldn't hurt. Can you not go around that corner?
Silence! The RS getting all excited. Oh, look, I'm going to vault. It's going to be amazing. Okay, where's the Aureus?
You're near the top. Yeah.